Good morning, everybody, and welcome back to normal life. I will most likely put this video up before my Disney videos because I just haven't had a chance to sit down and even start looking at that footage. So we are back from Disney. We had a fantastic trip. It was full of so much just like Disney magic from the cast members. Cast members were great. The resort was great. The kids had a really good time. You know, we did have some meltdowns from Trevor, but you know, that's just kind of what we expect. When he doesn't get his way, he cries, but he does it really loud because I think he thinks that like people will give him pity. But it was funny. We had a situation where there was an older gentleman behind us and he heard what Trevor did. Like Trevor, like Aubrey was close to him and he like nudged her like that. And we're like, we don't hit our sisters. I didn't hit her. She was crowding on me. So, you know, she fell on me. And the guy was like, so my husband, you know, kind of disciplined him or whatever. And then, he starts crying and da da da. And the guy was like, and it was a Southern guy. He's like, young man. He's like, I saw what you did there. Da da da. And his face was like, oh crap. So it was like, you know, we had a few situations like that. Ellie definitely had her moments. She's three. She doesn't get to ride as much as the big kids do. So we had to really kind of like turn things around. And, you know, there was a few times and there was a morning when I took her and just her and I went off and did our own thing. And we did it so that she could ride every single thing. And she was so happy with that. So, I think a lot of her stuff was, you know, with that, her and Casey got sick on the way down, and then her and Casey kept getting this cold and passing it back and forth to one another, and on the way home, Casey was full-fledged sick the last few days. I now have it, Aubrey has it, so we did have a little sickness going around, but other than that, I mean, it was a fantastic trip. I have no complaints, I don't think. You know, there was a few things that were like, eh, but I have no complaints at all. And, you know, we were talking like DVC this trip. We were talking going back for the fall for like the kids' birthdays, the younger three, and then going back around Christmas time for Trevor's birthday. Just fantastic trip. As for the house, everything for the house got done. We left and the house went on the market that day around 3. We had a couple showings that night. We had like in the teens showings the next day and the teens showing the following day and then a few showings the last day. After the day that it went on the market around the 3rd, around 5 or 6, no, it was the next morning around 9 a.m., my realtor emailed me and said, we need to start figuring out a plan because I expect multiple offers. And I said, yep. I said, let's pick a day and a time and just tell them best, you know, best offer. So long story short, we got 10 offers and we had 30 showings. So we had a third of the people that looked at the house want to buy it. And I think that that's really cool because there's a lot of things that go against this house and I'm shocked. I would have been surprised if it, I mean, I would have thought it would have been like 2 to 3 offers and I would have thought they would have been weaker offers, but we actually got an over asking price offer, nothing back. So it's like, we did really good in that aspect. And then all the feedback, what time is it?
7:45.
And then all the feedback on it was really, really, really good. So that's great. Today's actually the inspection. So I'm going to be getting the house kind of cleaned up, and then I got to get out of the house for like 2 to 3 hours with the cat, the dog, and 2 of the kids. So I'm going to take the kids to school and then we're going to start working on getting it cleaned up for the inspector. Sorry for the obnoxious noise you're about to hear. The dog likes ice and I just dropped a piece on the floor. So it was, I mean, it was kind of chaotic because like when we first arrived, I'm like, you know, when we're in the airport, everything, I'm like, why isn't it online? Why isn't it online? Checking everything, checking my agent site. And I was really frustrated with it. And then we were in the Nemo thing, and that's when I got the message that it went online. And then I looked online and all of a sudden like a bunch of houses went up in our area or in our town. And so I don't know if it was just like a MLS thing, like if it was just down or whatever. So once it went up, we started immediately getting, like, I had like a website that was for my showings, and then I had a website that was like for my offers, and it was just nonstop emails. And you know, as we would get the offers in, we would look over them and just kind of prioritize them, which ones we wanted to do. Because for us, we wanted to avoid, we have an FHA loan, we wanted to avoid that, we wanted to avoid VA loans, we wanted to avoid, like, not today, baby, not today. We wanted to avoid like the first time home buyer loans, and nothing against them at all. I am all for people protecting our country. I'm all for people buying their first home. I just know the HELL that we had getting this house, because they're really picky with certain things. And then there are certain things, like, they were so fixated on the back of our house that the paint was peeling, when in reality, the people had painted the front areas of our house because it was so much, it was in such worse shape. But because it was painted, they didn't even realize how bad of shape it was. And then, like, you know, they complained about a lot of stupid stuff, but then they totally missed the fact that this window in our dining room, there was no window in it. It was a piece of glass sitting on top of it. So it was like, you know, because I posted something on my Facebook, and I had a girl, like, go off about it because, like, she took it personally. And I'm like, they're not, my house isn't a dump. First of all, don't call my house a dump. I'm like, but, you know, there are just some things that they're a little bit ridiculous with. And there are some things that I know my husband can go into a house, and as long as it's not like a structural thing, he can fix pretty much everything. So it's like, certain things don't scare us. They just don't. Like, I know, Keisha, I almost killed you. Like, with this house, I know that we had, like, in our garage, there's like a little tiny sliver of termite damage. And the home inspector didn't even write it down because he knew that that would make us lose the house. And literally, Jeff came in when we first got here. He cut out this piece of trim. He put this, like, stuff in there to kill him. Put a new piece of wood up. We've never had an issue since. If that were FHA, we wouldn't have got this house for that little tiny square. And it's like, things like that don't scare me. They don't. My husband takes care of it. And it's here 8 years later, and they're not back. So it's like, you know, we had to go through and really kind of cherry pick what we wanted and what we didn't want. But in the end, all things worked out. So we are in the first week of May now. The only thing we countered with them is they wanted a June 3rd closing date. And you know, we were going back and forth with the people down in Georgia, and you know, they still don't know when the house is going to be ready because the people didn't move out until the 1st of May. We went ahead and pushed it back to like mid-June instead of early June. So I'm actually going to take the kids out of school early, though. I'm going to take them out of school around Memorial Day because I think that they need a summer. I don't think it's fair that they would go to school here until mid-June and then start August 1st. So that is on my, you know, radar to-do list as well. But today is the inspection. Next Thursday is the appraisal. Already filling out title paperwork. It's like crazy. I met with my mom yesterday, and she gave me a lot of boxes, and she's starting to, I think it's starting to hit her, and she's getting a little bit sentimental about it. So, yeah, it's moving really, really, really fast.
Mommy,
not right now, Ellie. Mommy's got to get the house clean. But yeah, so I'm going to try to get the house, you know, I was going to try to get it show ready, but that ain't happening. I feel like poop. So I'm just going to get the house as clean as I can, and then go get Casey, and then come back and get the animals, and then, there's like some stuff I can do. Like, I dropped my phone when we were in Florida and the tempered glass thing broke. So I'm gonna see if my phone is right to show you. Oh, it's in my back pocket. Well, you can see my fast passes, but if you can see that, I like cracked. So to see if they'll fix that. We have some cabinets in our kitchen that broke, and we have like a lifetime warranty on those, so I wanted to get those fixed before the people move in or just leave them here for them. What else I need to do? I can go grocery shopping and stuff like that. So, yeah, sorry it's been so chatty, but I'm going to try to get this done real quick and be able to sit down a little bit before I have to go. Because having the cat, the dog, and two of the four kids in the car is going to be a little bit chaotic. But, you know, it is what it is. You do what you got to do. And this weekend, we are going to take Trevor to see Civil War. Because he came home and he had a lot of makeup work. And he really, like, buckled down and got it done. So I was really proud of him for that. So, taking him to see the new Civil War movie. And Aubrey's got softball. Celebrating Mother's Day. I think that's it. So, yeah, let me get going and shut up. Alright, so my upstairs is clean. I like even like clean my garbage disposal and stuff like that. In a minute, Ellie. So I have dishes here that are just I just hand washed and dried. And then I need to bring this stuff downstairs. And then this pile of stuff is stuff that's going with me. So it's 9:25 now, so I don't have to leave for another like hour.
Are we going to the house to bring stuff yet?
The post office, yes. I have about an hour and 15 minutes, so I gotta really kind of hustle to get the, what do you want, cheese?
Yogurt.
No, no yogurt right now, because I don't want to have to clean another dish. So it's gotta be something that doesn't need a spoon. So you have cheese, you have apples, grapes, strawberries.
Wait.
In a bowl. So, yeah, I'm gonna have to kind of hustle to get it all done, but I think I'll be able to get it done. I wanted to get the kids' Disney haul filmed because all their stuff is all over the basement and they've already started going into stuff, and I wanted to kind of show you guys, but this may be the one trip that we don't get a Disney haul filmed just because I need to get the stuff put away. And I don't want to have to sit there and like try to, you know, dig and everything and try to find it. So we'll see. But you know, once we have this hurdle to get through, it's really just the appraisal and then getting all the like paperwork signed for the new house that we're renting. And my husband already has all of his paperwork for work. They're done, but he does need to take a drug test, but like he can't take one here, so I don't know. It's all definitely falling into place, and I feel a lot more at ease about everything. So the house is as clean as it's gonna get. I wish it was a little bit better because like I have a box that's in the playroom that has our Disney stuff.
She's in the studio.
Yeah, she's just trying to get warm. But you know, it is what it is. It's just an inspection. I'm not even sure if they're going to be here because my realtor is going to be here. So I would I don't know. I know when we had ours, it was our realtor that was here. But we bought in a totally different situation. We bought a short sale. So yeah. So I'm just going to put these dishes away. I took the laundry out of the washing machine. Like my laundry room has laundry in it. But, you know, it is what it is. I'm not. I got to get caught up on laundry. I don't want to get all stuck with that stuff. So I'm gonna try to organize my purse a little bit better because this is the purse I was using before we left and it's like a mess. And there's another purse of mine that's just thrown in the closet. And I mean, it is 10 o'clock. I could work a little bit harder, but I'm like short of breath with this stupid cold. So yeah, give me a second. And I have the dog outside, so it doesn't smell too bad in here, like a dog. So we are in the car. I picked up Aubrey from her little garden club and all that. We had the inspection. When it was the inspection, I went and picked up some cabinet doors. I tried to get my phone fixed, but they're out of the tempered glass until like Wednesday. I went and got my mom her Mother's Day card. And last night at Target, I swear I got her a card, but apparently I didn't even pay for it, so I have to go back and try to find that card. And I really liked it because it was just really funny and like totally to us. sorry, you guys are changing. But so the boys are going to see Civil War tonight, and I am taking the girls, and we are going to Costco and Target and Market Basket, and we're gonna get, you know, groceries and stuff like that. What else did we have to do today? Oh, I am wearing my seatbelt. I got a lot of flack in the past few videos, and I will say I do not wear my seatbelt simply because it's the law in New Hampshire. In New Hampshire, you don't have to wear your seatbelt above 16 or 18, I forget. Like, you don't have to wear, like, helmets and motorcycles and stuff like that. And not that it's okay. I understand that it's stupid to not wear my seatbelt because if I get into an accident, it doesn't matter what the law is, I can be hurt. But it's just one of those things. I hate wearing them. They annoy me. And I just don't wear them, but I'm trying to get better at it because that is not the law in Georgia, and I will have to wear them, so, there's that. But, yeah, so it's just kind of like a girls' night, boys' night. This is the boys', like, you know, monthly date night, and then we'll find something fun for the girls to do. I do have those two passes for the butterfly place, so maybe next weekend when Jeff's off of work on Saturday, I can take them to that before we lose those passes, because obviously we can't use them when we're in Georgia. But I did hear from my realtor and my neighbors. I had them spying on them. And he said that the home inspection seemed to go really well. It was really uneventful. There were just some, like, minor things that came up and, like, typical wear and tear stuff. And the one thing that he did mention was something that they mentioned in our home inspection. And it's just, like, it's a really cheap fix. Like, you can pay a company anywhere from like $200 to at the very most $500 to do it, or you can even do it yourself or even cheaper. So feeling kind of good about that we won't be nickel and dimed as much. And it's like, it's seeming like we're getting closer and closer and closer to having that, like, full year salary almost in our bank account. So it'll be the equivalent of us working, like, probably like January through like mid to late October. I'd say late October. So that's pretty freaking sweet. I'm pretty stoked about that. So I did talk to the kids' schools today, like, both in Georgia and in New Hampshire, to make sure that I have that. So I decided the kids are gonna have 3 more weeks of school, and then I'm taking them out. So yeah, I want to get all of the kids' teachers a gift, like a teacher appreciation gift, like you do at the end of the year. I want to make sure that all the teachers get one of those and have all that. So yeah, so now I think we'll do Target first, and then I'll take the girls into the mall and get them dinner, and then we'll run to Costco and then Market Basket last. And worst case scenario, I can do Market Basket tomorrow. So who's gonna wake up Ellie? 1, 2, 3, not it.
Too, anyway.
Yeah, good luck with that. And now we gotta try to get her to wake up and then walk, because I don't have a stroller anymore.
Wanna go to the ball after?
Oh,
she just...
Oh, there we go. Ellie, do you want to go to the mall? We're at the mall.
And we have candy.
And we're gonna go to Target, and then we'll go get you some lunch. I mean, some dinner.
Except we're having dinner now.
Ellie, do you want to wake up?
Just...
Oh, you're such your mother's child when you wake up.
Your seat.
Are you like mommy when you wake up? Yeah, we're not getting that. Put it back. Don't kiss stuff, Ellie. You're gonna get sick. It's disgusting.
Please, can I have it?
This would go cute with that bedding we just saw.
Yeah.